Sketching is the original form of astronomical imaging since prehistoric times and then from Galileo. Photography has largely taken up the image capture of astronomical objects. However, photography does not give a true representation of how things appear through the eyepiece. Scott Mellish developed a method of sketching that not only overcomes some of the technical difficulties of traditional sketching techniques, but it is also very simple and very powerful. The Mellish Technique. The core method of the Mellish Technique is dry brush painting using soft pastel powder. For this, we use a variety of roundhead and bristle brushes, white soft pastel and charcoal pencils, fine sandpaper to produce the powder on, and a white gel pen for highlights. There are two basic techniques used, dry brush painting and direct pencil drawing. In dry brush painting, we make a powder by braiding the soft pastel onto the sandpaper, and it's then a matter of dipping the brush onto the powder. The technique to master is the actual control of the loading of the brush. Too much powder on the brush and we have no control over the intensity of the application. And it's a matter of constantly flicking the brush to give the intensity that we want and intensity control. In direct pencil drawing, we are creating stars and developing detail. Stars are spots or pinpoints of light. But a pencil can only give so much intensity. If we want a brighter star, we need to then use a gel pen. For the brighter stars, we can add diffraction spikes. And for the very brightest of stars, we can then apply a glare spot with a brush. Galaxies, globular clusters, and nebulae. Galaxies. The faintest galaxies observable are essentially just soft spots. Spiral galaxies, we first start with the central hub. Nice and soft details. The arms can then start being developed. Or if there's a bar, we develop the bar as well. The softest of details we first apply. Constantly flicking the brush. And slowly developing the layers. Then details can be added, such as developing the central hub, a little bit more intense, a little bit denser. Sometimes we need to extend the central hub. And then we start adding finer details such as leading edges, and these are usually mottled as well with him. Now I find the easiest eraser to use is one's finger. And then the final detail to add are foreground stars. Edge on galaxies are started from the central hub and the full extent of the disk. Don't worry about the dark lane at this stage. That's a detail that's added towards the end. We then continue on by developing the core and the arms, the disc, even the underside as well. Again, don't worry about the dark lane. Because we're layering the powders on, soft pastels are very forgiving for this. And the dark line is first developed as a line drawing. Then developed dry brushing. Using the charcoal and the white pastel to develop details and any mottling that appears. And correcting. So forgiving is charcoal and soft pastel. That's what I use also to make corrections. Globular clusters have traditionally been the most difficult to sketch. The Mellish technique offers a very simple and highly effective way to reproduce them. As for galaxies, we begin with the softest of details. This gives us scale and starts developing the depth that we so desperately seek. We then start developing the core. Always flick your brush. Control how it's loaded. And here is where the bristle brush comes into its own. Use it to grind in the most intense part of the core. Continue certain development of the halo. Reestablish the density. When we're satisfied, we can start developing the signature star patterns. Remember, stars are pinpoints, so we need to be constantly sharpening our pencils. Signature patterns are the patterns that we can actually take time to develop, chasing them down. Each globular cluster has its own unique set of signature patterns. Something like M4 has a distinct belt across its middle. As we're not going to be laying out every single individual star, which is impossible, Scott came up with a method I call machine gunning, where we develop the brilliance of the globular cluster by pop marking the softest of stars. It's a random development. We're not too concerned about the placement of these because they're not really the signature stars. But we can use it to develop certain mottlings and also develop those particularly bright stars that are in most cases just foreground stars. Always sharpen your pencil. My drawings, I always extend beyond what we perceive as the immediate galaxy or globular cluster or open cluster, because we cannot ever be sure where it ends, and it also puts the cluster or galaxy into context with its surroundings. Nebulae are a blend of the styles used with galaxies and globular clusters. Unlike typical sketching techniques, where we will begin with the brightest of details, we here begin with the softest. This allows us to develop both the scale and the overall structure. Details are added in layers. And as with galaxies, we leave any dark details towards the end. We start developing highlights. Again, we don't have any stars at the moment, we are developing the structures. Stars are added towards the end. We can use a bristle brush to give us very strong contrasts, which are then softened with a brush. Leading edges can be applied. Extensions added. Leading edges can also be cutting. Gives crazy control of sharp details. Details such as the dark pillars can be started by drawing them in first. As this can be quite intense and very hard edge. And then softened with a brush. And details continue to be developed. Shapes,
textures. Volume and intensity. And sometimes there is a bright edge that we can add. In this case, the trapezium. And the final details are the stars. Find them as needed. And making corrections.
Thank you for watching this tutorial video. If you have any questions, please email me through the link below or through my blog site, alexanderastrosketching.blogspot.com. Thank you.